It is in this context, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, that the decision to establish the specialized anti-corruption courts must be understood. The obvious advantage presented by the establishment of the special courts is that corruption cases are prioritized. They no longer need to join the routinely long queues which the ordinary cases go through to be heard in court. That results in expeditious resolution of the cases, which in turn gives the public confidence in government's effort in dealing with corruption. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, the opening of these specialized anti-corruption courts remains inseparable from government's vision to transform Zimbabwe into an upper middle income economy by 2030. There is always the risk of capital flight attendant upon any economy riddled with corruption. The economic turnaround of our nation remains in our hands. It is incumbent upon every well-intentioned Zimbabwean to play his or her part in this struggle in order to create a conducive environment for both domestic and foreign investment. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to applaud the inter-agency cooperation which now exists between and amongst stakeholders in the administration of justice. That unity of purpose has been pivotal to the successes that have been scored so far. It takes tireless effort, perseverance, and unhesitant deployment of resources for a country to weed out corruption. I assure you that the Zimbabwe Anti-Corruption Commission and its partners are built with these characteristics. ZAC and the Zimbabwe Republic Police will not tire in investigating corruption and making arrests where those are called for. The National Prosecuting Authority on its part must always stand ready to diligently prosecute cases and the courts to play their adjudicative role without fear or favor until the whole of Zimbabwe is rid of corruption. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I seek your indulgence to briefly apprise you of some of the initiatives that have been taken by players in the fight against corruption, which complement the establishment of these special courts by the Judicial Service Committee. The agreement entails collaboration with our Zambian counterparts in joint investigations, mutual assistance, the exchange of crime intelligence, the recovery of proceeds of crime, and exchange of skilled personnel, among other issues. To cap it all, the Commission crafted a strategic plan for the period 2020 to 2024, intended to guide its operations.
Yes, I can read the plaque. It's the plaque here. This specialized anti-corruption courtroom was officially commissioned by the chairperson of the Zimbabwe Anti-Corruption Commission, Honorable Mrs. Justice L. Matanda Moyo.